लेट अस डिस्कस सम प्रॉब्लम्स ऑन किरचॉफ्स रूल्स। ए बैटरी ऑफ 10 वोल्ट एंड नेग्लिजिबल इंटरनल रेजिस्टेंस इज कनेक्टेड अक्रॉस द डायगोनली ऑपोजिट कॉर्नर्स ऑफ ए क्यूबिकल नेटवर्क कंसिस्टिंग ऑफ 12 रेजिस्टर्स ईच ऑफ रेजिस्टेंस 1 ओम। सो यू सी इन दिस फिगर दिस इज ए क्यूबिकल नेटवर्क हैविंग 12 resistors and the diagonally opposite corners, this one and this point, the point A and point C, C dash, are diagonally opposite corners and they are connected by a 10 volt battery and we have to find out the equivalent resistance of the network and the current along each edge of the cube. You see, the network is not reducible to simple series and parallel combinations of resistors, but you can use the symmetry of the current flow. Suppose current flowing from this 10 volt battery is equal to 3i and the current through each branch through the branch AD and AB and A dash will be 1 ampere each, I ampere each. 3i will be equally distributed among these three branches due to the symmetry of the structure. So by using the symmetry of the structure and Kirchhoff's rule, we can find out the equivalent resistance. So as I have told you, let us the total current from this battery is equal to 3i and it is divided into three segments along A dash I, along AD I, along A B also equal to I. Again at A dash, the I current will be divided into I by 2 and I by 2 here. Similarly, this current I is divided into I by 2 here, here also I by 2. And here I by 2 and I by 2, the total current here will be equal to I. Similarly, at the point D, the current I will be divided into I by 2, here also I by 2. And at B, it is divided into I by 2, here also I by 2. So, here the total current will be equal to I. And here the total current will be equal to I. So, as shown in this figure, you can see how the current is distributed symmetrically. Now you apply Kirchhoff's voltage law to the loop A, B, C, C dash, E and A to this closed loop. So you see in this resistor the IR drop will be equal to minus IR and here in this resistor the IR drop will be equal to minus I by 2 into R and here the IR drop will be equal to minus IR. And here the total EMF will be equal to plus E because there is voltage rise or potential rise, the EMF will be equal to plus E. So if you calculate the total potential drop and the EMF drop, that will be equal to minus IR minus I by 2 into R minus IR plus E, that is equal to 0. So E epsilon will be equal to IR plus I by 2 into R plus IR. So if you solve it, it will be equal to 5 by 2 into IR. So the equivalent resistance of the network will be equal to R equivalent total EMF divided by total current. Total EMF we have calculated 5 by 2 into IR and the total current is equal to 3I. So R equivalent will be equal to 5 by 6 into R. But it is given that the resistance is equal to R is equal to 1 ohm. So R equivalent will be equal to 5 by 6 ohm. Next, we have to calculate the current through each resistance. Here the total current 3I is equal to voltage or EMF divided by R equivalent effective resistance. Voltage is given, EMF is given 10 volt and R equivalent we have calculated 5 by 6 ohm. So current will be equal to 4 ampere. So current through each edge can be calculated. since current through this resistor is equal to 4 ampere, through this resistor 4 ampere, through this resistor 4 ampere, through this resistor 2 ampere, because it is I by 2. So similarly you can calculate the current through each resistor. Let us work out another problem. Determine the current in each branch of the network as shown in the figure. So in this figure, in this network, you have three unknown current. In from this EMF 10 volt, suppose a current I1 is moving, I1 current is traveling through the point A, and at A, the I1 current will be divided into two currents. One is your I2, another one is I1 minus I2. So through this resistance 4 ohm current is I2, and through this resistance 4 ohm current is I1 minus I2, and from this EMF of 5 volt the current, let us say, is equal to I3. So there are three unknown currents. One is your I1, another I2, and another, the third one is I3. So at the point B, from here the current is coming I2, and from here the current is coming I3. So through this resistance 2 ohm, the current will be equal to I2 plus I3. And at C, you have current I2 plus I3 minus I1 through this resistance 2 ohm, and through this 1 ohm resistance I1. That is why through this resistance, the total current will be equal to I2 plus I3 minus I1, as you see in this figure. And at D, the current is coming from this side, I2 plus I3 minus I1, and current is coming from this side, I1 minus I2. So net current here will be equal to I3. Okay, so I3 current will move towards the point E. Now you have three loops. One is your A, D, C, A. This is one closed loop. The second one is A, B, C, A. This is another closed loop. And the third loop is B, C, D, E, B. So in these three loops, you apply Kirchhoff's voltage law. So first, considering the loop C, A, D, C, the voltage here will be equal to plus 10 volt because of there is rise in potential. So the voltage drop here will be equal to plus 10 volt, and the IR drop here at I1 minus I2, this will be equal to negative because of there is fall in potential. So here the potential drop will be equal to minus 4 into I1 minus I2. Then here the potential drop or IR drop will be equal to I2 plus I3 minus I1 into 2, and it will be plus because there is a rise of potential here. And at 1 ohm, the potential drop or the IR drop will be equal to minus I1. So this will be equal to 10 into 4, 10 minus 4 into I1 minus I2 plus 2 into I2 plus I3 minus I1. Minus I1 is equal to 0, or if you rearrange the terms, it will be equal to 7 I1 minus 6 I2 minus 2 I3, that will be equal to 10. And in this loop DA, CB, CD, we have considered the clockwise notation of the loop. Here also, in the loop A, B, C, A, if you consider the clockwise notation of the loop, then applying KVL to this loop, it will be equal to 10 for this because of there is voltage rise. So EMF will be equal to, or voltage drop here will be equal to 10, and for this resistor IR drop will be equal to minus 4 I2, and for this resistor it will be equal to minus 2 into I2 plus I3, and for this resistor it will be equal to minus I1. So applying KVL to the loop ABCA, you get this equation. Similarly, applying KVL to the loop BCDEB, you get this equation. And if you solve equation 1 and 2, I1 will be equal to 2.5 ampere. And by solving equation 2 and 3, I2 will be equal to 5 by 8 ampere. and putting I1, I2 in equation 2, you will get I3 will be equal to 15 by 8 ampere.